Tesla stock is taking off yet again. Here to talk about what's behind this recent run-up is a special guest this week. We have Jeff Brown with Brownstone Research with us today. So glad that you could be here. You have been a big supporter and fan of Tesla for quite a few years now.
That's right. I first formally recommended Tesla back in April of 2018. And if you think back to that time, it was a very, very contentious stock. Some people were claiming it was a fraud, that the accounting was off, that they were losing money on every car that they sold, that it was destined to go bankrupt. I mean, there was so much negativity about Tesla back at that time. And the reason was the framework that they were looking at Tesla. The general thought was this is a car company. And so they were trying to measure the performance of Tesla in the same way that they were looking at, you know, Ford or General Motors. It was just the wrong framework. And to me, Tesla at that time had some material advantages over the rest of the industry. You know, they'd completely designed new manufacturing processes. Their efficiencies were very different than the traditional automotive industry. But the architecture of their cars, their vehicles, was different. You know, they designed a software system around which they built essentially a robot, actually. It was a car, or, you know, now it's actually a truck, but, you know, it was a computer architecture, and it was one that could be updated just like we update our PCs or our laptops today with regular software updates. You didn't have to bring them into the dealer anymore. Tesla also had some real breakthroughs in terms of their lithium-ion battery chemistries in particular, which gave them also another advantage over the rest of the electric vehicle makers. So not just the rest of the automotive industry, but EV makers. But really at the very center of my investment thesis around Tesla was all about artificial intelligence. And the point I made back in 2018, which no one was talking about, was that Tesla was, at that time, one of the world's most successful artificial intelligence companies. And that AI development was going to be the secret to its future growth. And that was April 2018.
Well, it's certainly paying off today. They are, like you said, a major AI leader, and their stock price is absolutely going through the roof right now. Ever since the election, Tesla has seen incredible growth.
Yeah.
What's behind some of this recent growth and this resurgence in their stock price?
Well, you know, it's really interesting because up until, I would say, 6 weeks ago, generally speaking, the industry, Wall Street, was really looking at Tesla as still an EV manufacturer. And they're actually quite negative because, as a whole, electric vehicle sales were declining. So not Tesla in particular, but there was this sentiment in the market that the electric vehicle industry was kind of suffering and slowing down a bit, and they were kind of projecting that would continue over the next few years. And then we really turned a corner. I think a lot of people are suggesting that it was because of what the outcome of the elections and because of Musk's role in the Trump administration, that's why the stock's running, but that's not really what's happening. What's happening is this series of announcements that Tesla's had regarding its artificial intelligence. So specifically, its autonomous driving technology, which is an artificial neural network that they've been developing over a number of years. And what's been extraordinary is what's happened in the next, or in the last, I would say, 3 or 4 months. So Tesla had been releasing a series of new full self-driving, they call it full self-driving, it's autonomous driving technology, FSD, new versions of its FSD software on its Teslas. And I have a Tesla, which I have just to test every new software release. So I can track these things very closely. Anyway, what happened was there were very rapid improvements in the self-driving software over these 3 or 4 months. And in fact, on November 30th, it released its latest version, which is version 13.2. And 13 was the version that had been spoken of as the solution to essentially fully autonomous software. So level five, which has the capability of what we would refer to as unsupervised self-driving. So what does unsupervised mean? It means literally you can get into the car, sit back, take a nap, and basically be transported to your destination without having to do a thing. And so, you know, what's happened since version 13 came out is it is phenomenal. Its performance is really unbelievable. I mean, it was fabulous 3 months ago, but where version 13 is truly remarkable. It's incredibly human in terms of the way that it drives. You know, it's just aggressive enough. It's can get through very complex situations very naturally. It's extremely smooth. And anyone, any analyst who has actually experienced it can know when they experience what that looks like, that something very special is happening. And so the kind of importance, the importance of this particular event is that, you know, Tesla is planning on getting approval for unsupervised self-driving technology in at least two states next year. And the front runners are Texas and California. And once that happens, he's planning on announcing his RoboTaxi network. And so any Tesla owner or even someone that's leased a Tesla can opt in their car into Tesla's future RoboTaxi network. So when you're not using your car, you hit your smartphone, you tell your Tesla to go out and work for you, and it generates income every day. If your Tesla is generating enough income for you on a monthly basis to pay for your monthly car loan or monthly lease, do you think more Teslas will be sold? It's pretty simple. It pays for itself. And so that's what's happening with this stock right now. They've recognized more broadly what the implications of this technology are for Tesla as a company. Not only will this increase sales of its own EVs, by the way, not other companies' EVs, but Tesla EVs, because they have both the hardware and software to enable this level five unsupervised driving. But it's also the foundation for what it recently announced. I'm sure you saw the Cybercab announcement, right? Pretty futuristic.
Absolutely.
Looking car, self-driving car, no brake, no accelerator, no steering wheel, just a screen, two seats. That's it. Phenomenal, right? But now that you see how version 13 is working, you can see that those cars will in fact work. People are starting to really see what the long-term strategy is for Tesla, and now that they can see that technology is very real, the rest, the future revenues that are forecasted from things like the Cybercab, you can also believe are coming as well. And that's why the stock is running so high.
Yeah, this seems like just the beginning of the move for Tesla with all of this future growth on the horizon. I think this is such an interesting point about AI in general, where the first versions of AI were not good on any part, whether it was image generation, video generation. The first versions, everyone almost laughed at as this is never going to be good. And now we're seeing it's phenomenal. And I think that's the same thing with this Tesla's version of AI and using it to make these self-driving vehicles. You have really found some other companies that are really going to start taking off thanks to the self-driving technology, correct?
Yes. So, you know, one of the things that I specialize in my own research and analysis is identifying these large technological trends. And then, of course, the companies that will benefit from it. You know, the tailwind here in this case is the ability to enable fully autonomous driving. So, you know, where I spend my time researching is first understanding the technology. Like I said, that's why I have a Tesla. And what was really interesting in with that technology is it wasn't the state of the technology at any given point in time. It was the rate of improvement. And that's what I think most people missed over the last few years. You know, yes, it wasn't perfect to the point that you made, but how rapidly was it improving? So if you're watching that, you could see that the rate of improvements was accelerating, which is why I knew this was happening this year. And so understanding the impact that Tesla is going to have on the industry, and then understanding those other companies that contribute to this trend, that might even enable Tesla, for example, companies that provide specialized components into Tesla vehicles and potentially future Tesla products like the Cybercab or like Optimus, their humanoid robot, which has generated so much excitement as well.
You clearly speak from a place of knowledge on so much of this. What's your background a little bit? And give us some background on your company as well.
I am a technologist at heart. My undergraduate degree was in aeronautical and astronautical engineering from Purdue University. So I have a very technical engineering background. I worked in industry for about 25 years as a corporate high-tech executive for a variety of companies that were in wireless and wireline communications, internet technology, routers, switches. I worked for a couple major semiconductor companies like Qualcomm and NXP Semiconductors. Have a lot of experience in software and cybersecurity as well. And so a wide range of experience through many different technology verticals. As a business executive, as a technologist, and really managing, running large operating businesses for technology companies. And I did that up until about 2014, and then made a change in my career to become an investment analyst, a technology analyst, to focus on high tech and biotechnology, which is what I've been doing for about the last 10 years. So all that time in the field, customer facing, understanding how products are bought and sold, you know, what makes a product compelling in terms of market adoption is a really important part of my analysis. And I bring all that to Brownstone Research, which is one of the largest and most successful investment research companies in the world over the last 10 years. And all I can say is I can't imagine a more exciting time to be doing this kind of work with what's coming around the corner over the next few years. It's really a remarkable period in history.
It really is. And it's paying off in huge ways in the stock market as well. We continue to see company after company, anything to do with AI, seeing some major payoffs. And I think understanding that technology is why you have such an advantage in understanding how to invest in that as well. Your latest video is a wealth of information. Again, talking a lot about Tesla and also talking about the companies that could benefit alongside Tesla. And so we have that link here if you want to check out Jeff's latest video. Watch the full thing because it's very, very, very interesting and informative. You, again, so much knowledge. Thank you for sharing that with
You're
us.
You're very welcome.
And with our viewers here on MarketBeat. Thank you so much for joining us today, everyone. Again, check out the description for that link to Jeff's latest video. Thanks again for watching, everyone. And as always, happy investing.